The following program may contain coarse language, violence, nudity, mature subject matter, or scenes which may not be suitable for all viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
This is the Exxon Broadcast Network, broadcasting worldwide on broadcast affiliates and satellite program providers, including CNN Broadcast Network, Sirius Satellite Network, Star Media, Good News Radio Network, Angel Broadcast Network, Wiki Broadcast Network, and WPBN-TV. For more information on the X-Zone Broadcast Network, visit us at www.xzbn.net.
From our broadcast studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, to the world and beyond, you're watching the X-Zone Broadcast Network, www.xzbn.net.
AVS Media Demo.
Papa Hotel, Lima Echo November, radio check.
Papa Echo November, good afternoon, Ritchie 5.
Good afternoon, Ritchie 5 as well, Papa Echo November.
The X-Zone radio and TV show is largely an opinion talk show. All opinions, comments, or statements of fact expressed by Rob McConnell's guests are strictly their own and are not to be construed as those of the X-Zone radio and TV show or in any manner endorsed by Rob McConnell, Relmar McConnell Media Company, Talkstar Radio Network, its affiliated stations, or employees.
Welcome back to the X-Zone, everyone. My name is Rob McConnell, coming to you from our studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Worldwide toll-free 1-800-610-7035. Email X-Zone at XZoneRadioTV.com. On MSN Messenger, XZoneRadioTV at Hotmail.com. And our website, www.XZoneRadioTV.com. Don't forget X-Zone Nation. In a couple of days, all of our interviews will be available on Amazon.com, as well as our books, our newspaper, and our CDs. All you have to do is go to www.amazon.com. In the search engine, type in REL-MAR.com or Rob McConnell along with that, and all our products will show up. And we're really excited about partnering with Amazon.com. My guest this hour is talking about a question that became very, very newsworthy last week. We're asking the question, is America prepared for a massive cyber attack? X-Zone Nation, as you recall, last week it was found out that the Chinese military has been very actively snooping on our cyber, our banking institutions, government institutions. They've been taking intelligent... designs, and they're bringing it over to China, making it a lot cheaper. It's something that President Obama said to Congress that they must heed during his State of the Union plea going back just a couple of weeks ago. The threat of cyber warfare has suddenly become very real. And as you know, with President Obama signing an executive order mandating development of standards to protect the computer systems that run critical sectors of the economy and directing U.S. defense and intelligence agencies to share classified threat data with those companies. In his State of the Union address, he urged Congress to pass even tougher measures. And cyber warriors will even be eligible for their own combat-related medal soon. The Pentagon has announced it's creating a Distinguished Warfare Medal, the first new medal since the Bronze Star in 1944, to recognize soldiers who excel in cyber and drone attacks. It's a start, but only a start. And that's according to our guest this hour, Charles D. Martin, whose novel, Provocateur, includes a chillingly realistic cyber attack on the U.S. Treasury. His website is www.provocateurbook.com. And joining me now from sunny and warm California is our guest this hour, Charles Martin. And Charles, welcome to the X-Zone.
Well, Rob, thank you for having me on your show.
It's our great pleasure, sir.
I'm glad I don't have to be there in person. I have to thaw out.
I think I'm going to send you a bucket of snow.
Okay, that'd be good.
Yeah. No, wait a minute. I'm just giving you something to cool off in that beautiful weather with. Nah, to heck with it. You're just going to have to suffer in the heat. Cyber attacks. Last week, the Chinese were, exposed as doing a lot of bad things using cyber technology on the United States and other countries. I would imagine that we're going to be seeing a lot more of cyber attacks compared to actual physical combat in the future.
You know, I think that's absolutely right. We're only in the first inning of this game. Already we see attacks that are troubling. One of the new developments that came out of the recent China matter is, we're beginning to develop the technology to trace where these cyber attacks come from.
Wow.
And we've never been able to do that before. The attacks would occur and you just didn't know who the perpetrator was of it. But, as a cyber security company, Matreon is its name, that has developed technology to trace these.
Well, let's talk more about this when we come back from this two-minute commercial break. ExoNation, Charles D. Martin is my very special guest this hour. His website is provocateurbook.com. More on cyber attacks on the other side of this commercial break as we continue from our studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Don't go away.
Modern Esoteric, Beyond Our Senses by Brad Olson, consummates the lifeology story about where humanity originates. It is the lost continents, the primitive wisdom, the mythos of creation, and the rethinking of ancient history as we are taught in academia. There is much more to the story than what we have been told. As this is the first book in the Esoteric series, Modern Esoteric starts at the beginning of time and accelerates up to this modern age. Future Esoteric is book two in the series and takes a forward-looking position ahead of today with an open and honest examination of the ET issue and various unexplained phenomena. To discover the writings of author Brad Olson, visit www.bradolson.com. That's www.bradolson.com. Named one of the world's greatest psychics, Elizabeth Joyce is now giving readings worldwide via Skype. Elizabeth Joyce is recognized for her clairvoyant ability to help find missing persons, her analysis of dreams, past life regression work, mediumship, and her accurate predictions. Elizabeth has been a frequent guest on the X-Zone radio show with yours truly, Rob McConnell, now for several years. For an appointment with Elizabeth Joyce, call 201-934-8986 or Skype at elizabeth.joyce. And for more information, you can always visit Elizabeth Joyce online at www.new-visions.com.
Have a disease that you would like to alleviate through a natural means? Have you been contacted by angels, ghosts, or even extraterrestrials and want to validate these experiences? Or would you simply like to speak with someone who can help you find your life's purpose? I'm Dr. Joseph Mara, and I'm offering my services free of charge for first-time clients contacting me during the month of April. These free consultations include angel card readings, guided meditations, life coaching, and energy healing. If you have always wanted to explore these types of experiences but were skeptical or simply could not afford them, then take advantage of this free special offer. Contact me through my website, aguidinglight.com, to schedule your consultation today. Until then, I offer you love, light, and laughter.
Yeah, that's where I'd like to be today after that blizzard we had. Oh, Lord. I was talking to Charles before we went on air, and he was saying it's 82, and they're expecting 82 degrees tomorrow in California. Oh, anyway, Charles Martin is my guest. He runs Mount Pelerin Capital, LLC, and serves on the investment committees of prominent universities, an established business writer. His first novel focuses on the intrigue that often exists between alpha females that take on and conquer dominant males. Charles lives with his wife in a coastal town south of Los Angeles, and his website is www.provocateurbook.com. Now, is it coincidence that you wrote this book and it's coming out just after all this information came to light about the Chinese government and what they're doing with our cyber units over here?
Well, it was written before this came out on the Chinese government thing. And there's been a history. It isn't like this is the new event to happen with the attack, you know. And what was new, as we were starting to talk about before the break, was that we are now getting the means to trace these cyber attacks and identify the attacker. And they were able to trace this back to an office building in Shanghai. And that office building is where the Chinese Army's cyber warfare unit is headquartered. Yeah, and that unit has a interesting name. There's no name. It's by a number. It's called Unit 61398. And so we were able to really determine who the cyber insurgent was in that case.
You know, we have several servers, and we can tell at any given time what the IP address is of who's ever coming to any of our sites. And by just doing a who is on the IP address, you can actually find out who that person is. In the past, we've had massive cyber attacks on our servers, and it is, you know, like, we're only a little company. And I can just imagine the peril that these cyber attacks can actually play on major companies, banks, corporations, even the Defense Department.
The mischief really has a broad range. You know, as you comment, the financial institutions, the banks, you know, these cyber attacks have gone in and pulled out credit card information and sometimes actually money. The recent China one was mostly on about 1,000 corporations.
Wow.
You know, stealing intellectual property and secret corporate information, but also, as you comment, they also spy on the U.S. military operations, and the fearful thing is that at some point they might be able to disrupt them.
Now, this begs to ask the question, are we doing the same thing to them?